My name is Gandi, and I'm a photographer, producing photographic art, and I'm always looking for a different perspective for my pieces and unusual subject matter. And here in Merida, there's certainly a lot of different subject matter, and I enjoy taking pictures of people, buildings, boats, landscape pictures, close-ups of unusual objects, anything that's a little bit out of the ordinary and that's going to catch people's eye. We're from England originally, my wife and I, and we moved to Lake Tahoe, California, where we spent 9 years running a business. And we decided that we wanted to slow down, have a little bit slower pace, and we had a very good friend here in Merida. He said, why don't you come down and take a look? And we were too busy really wrapping up what we were doing in California, and a very good friend said, I'll go to Merida and take a look for you, which she did. And 2 days later, she phoned us from Merida. She said, you've got to come and live in Merida. It's wonderful. The people are wonderful. The food's wonderful. So we just continued getting our bits and pieces sorted. And then we shipped our belongings, not all of them, just the precious pieces. And we came down, we got a flight, came down, didn't look back. We never saw it before we actually arrived. I've traveled all over the world, and most places in some ways have had a sort of similarity, but there's something about Merida, and a lot of other people that have moved here from America and Europe have said the same, that there's something special, and I think everybody finds it hard to really put their finger on that. I think it's the people more than anything. There's just no aggression like there is everywhere else. Everybody's just friendly and it's safe, and you can just go where you want, late at night, early in the morning. You just feel safe and comfortable all the time, which is just a wonderful feeling. When I go out to take pictures, I'll pick a day and I'll just go. And I don't think I have any particular favorite. I just keep finding new and different things that I've never seen anywhere else. And particularly some of the architectural things. I mean, they can be really old and worn, but they look wonderful. And the colors, I mean, they're just very vibrant colors. And I've always loved color and, you know, using and working with color. This picture here was one of my very, very lucky ones. I took a trip down with my camera to Zilam de Bravo and walked out onto one of the piers, which was rocking away on the ocean. And with a long zoom, I was able to catch the rear end of those seagulls. And this one, I don't know why, has been a particular favorite with the ladies. And the title of that one is called Bottoms Up. For fledgling photographers, I would first advice I would probably give is be aware constantly of your surroundings, because there's things all day, every day, that can just jump out that if you weren't thinking or thinking of wanting to, you know, capture beautiful photographs, you could miss so easily. I'm not saying you should be paranoid aware, but just be casually aware. And I see things all the time. I can be driving, I'll stop, I'll turn round, I'll go back. Or if I can't stop that day, I'll keep it in the memory and I'll go back to that spot. And then there's the different times of the day. Places can look totally different because of the sun. And it's just a big, big world out there, and there's so much to capture.